You're listening to The Michelle Mortensen Show, where facts matter.
You know I want you. It's not a secret I try to hide.
I know. Oh, The Greatest Showman. That was a great movie. A lot of people loved. Of course, that song is It's All in the Stars, right? And we are going to be talking about the stars and what the stars can tell us about this upcoming election. We didn't get to go through absolutely everything that I wanted to in the last break, but I do want to preface this. Governor Steve Sisolak later went on CNN with Chris Cuomo, and they talked specifically about the election, how he said that the things the president has been saying is not true, that the governor has not been in control of our election, that he's not trying to manipulate the election, that it's all the Secretary of State. I just want to say this right now. Our Secretary of State, Barbara Sagaski, is amazing. She has spoken out against the all mail-in ballot. And she was not really included in any of the decisions to go all mail. That was done by the Democrats. It was done by Governor Sisolak in the darkness of night. So he is 110% responsible for that. The other funny thing is Sisolak also said the June primary was fantastic as mail-in. We only had three places to go vote in person in Clark County. And of those three places, people were in line until 3 a.m. We did not get results for more than a week. We did not get official results for more than a week. And that was all due to the Democrat county commissioners who changed the way Clark County was going to do elections. There weren't problems like that in the rest of the state. That was, again, all because of the Democrats. So show me where the lie is. Yeah, the president ain't lying. The Democrats in this state are trying to make sure that this election is rigged. But we want to see what the stars have to say about this election. So I want to welcome Jeff Harman on the show right now. He is an astrologist, and he is an astrologist with an amazing record when it comes to predicting things like elections and chaos in years like 2020. Jeff, how are you?
Pretty good. Thanks for having me on.
We are very excited to have you on. Now, tell everyone, if they're not too familiar with you, you have been doing this for a very long time, and you have made a lot of predictions.
Well, I've been doing it a long time. Yes, about 45 years, actually. Yeah.
And you've predicted quite a few elections and quite a few things as to way things are going to go. I mentioned earlier at the top of the show that you actually had some predictions on the day that President Obama was inaugurated, that things weren't going to go as he planned, that things would be overturned.
Yep. He was actually inaugurated on a void of course moon, which often means everything that you do comes to nothing. And when you look at it, almost everything's been rescinded. Everything.
Wow.
Absolutely. Obamacare, many of the acts he's enacted and also executive orders. I mean, well, look what's happened. It's all been rescinded.
Absolutely. So I am curious then. You predicted that Donald Trump was going to win the election in January of 2016.
I did. I was on actually a couple of radio shows, and I thought they were going to hang up the phone on me. I literally thought they were going to just hang up the phone. How dare you say Donald Trump's going to win? And I said, well, he's going to win whether you like him or not. And I can tell you, I think he's going to win again.
Why do you say that? What are the stars telling
well,
you?
Well, it's not so much the stars. See, ancient astrology is very, very specific. It looks at things. I use a system called Vedic astrology, and it's more the planets than the stars, believe it or not. It's the solar system. It's actually very astronomy. I was actually a skeptic of astrology when I first got into it. I thought, come on, how can the effect of planets have anything on us? And it was my mother that got me into it in the 70s. And when I started looking at it, I said, oh my God, this is way past chance. Well, there's an ancient system in Vedic astrology called Nadi, N-A-D-I. And that's the one I saw, and also some Egyptian type of astrology that really showed Trump was going to take the election in, the 2016 when he won. And there was a number of things that said it. The same thing shows up now. He's definitely more powerful than Biden. I don't think we need astrology to even tell us that. I mean, if you look at Biden, it's fairly obvious. I mean, he's going to take a few Red Bulls and IV and maybe something else to get him to get through the debates. And, I wish him well. I'm not trying to be harsh on the guy, but it's just the way the chart looks. I mean, Trump just has the guns to pull this off. So for those that hate him, got bad news for you. It really looks to me like he's going to be in there again. And if anybody was aware of what was going on with this country, they might stop hating Donald Trump and start looking at the possibility that there's other things going on behind the scenes. And I was listening to your show about many of the things you're citing. And we have such political turmoil, not only in this country, but in the world. And the astrology actually shows we are in an unprecedented time of change. This hasn't happened since the beginning of the Industrial Revolution, which is, you know, almost 200 and something years ago. Benjamin Franklin, the founders of this country, actually were Masons, and they were really, really into astrology. And a lot of people find that hard to believe, but the signers of the Declaration of Independence were, I wouldn't say everyone, but a lot of them were very familiar with the ancient tenets of this type of astrology. And in fact, there's actually a mural of George Washington laying the cornerstone of the foundation with his Masonic apron on. And they did it at a good astrological time. And clearly, the United States has held world precedence and power from, I definitely say, the 1900s forward, clearly since World War II forward.
Well, and let me ask you this, too, because we want to know about some of the other elections as well. What are you seeing for the House of Representatives and the Senate? Are we seeing maybe the House flipping, maybe the Senate flipping? Do you have any?
I see the House and the Senate both going red. And I'll tell you why. The astrology shows people are afraid, really afraid. You know, many of the Vedic astrologers that I talk to and kind of coerce with, I would say that we're seeing cycles right now that really show the world morality has just gone out the window. And this is really a war between freedom and fascism. And I think there are forces out there, and many people have heard of them. You know, a lot of times we hear George Soros on the news, but I think there's forces behind that. They would love it. And the COVID was tied in with all this. I'm not saying the COVID isn't real, but there is an overt attempt right now to literally make a global economic structure. I'm talking to people all over the world, Australia, Europe, South America, people in the jungle, shamans. I mean, this COVID literally lockdown has affected everyone. And it's been incredible how effective it is. And many doctors, like on Tucker Carlson, who, you know, again, I would say he's almost a national treasure, some of the wonderful things he puts out. He was talking about, I think it was Dr. Scott, I forget his name, Atlas, was on, and I think he's on the COVID committee, where many doctors are being silenced on this. Well, I look at the astrology, and it's actually very much like that. We're seeing forces come in that literally want to lock down the entire system of freedom. And I hate to say this, but I think if you look closely, there are definitely communistic forces, and China sure seems to be intermixed into this. And I'm not being xenophobic, but I think we have forces right now where people are afraid, and they sure as heck should be, because it's not really, you know, the comedian George Carlin might have been right when he said, forget the politicians, you have owners. They print the money. And no one really knows who they are. They're certainly behind the scenes. And I think we have a war going on that's much deeper than just politics. The structures of this whole financial world are they're on the chopping
block. We are at war. Right now. We are at war financially. We are at war. We have a war against the police. We have racial strife going on right now. And so from what I've taken from you thus far, from me as a conservative Republican, I'm excited that you say 2020 is going to go red for the president, red for the Senate, red for Congress.
It leans that way. And I'll get hate mail. You got to remember, I live in California. I'm probably going to have a swarm of Priuses throw bricks through my window when we get done with the show.
Well, please let me know if that happens. I want to ask you as well, and you kind of were delving into it just a minute ago, that 2020 is quite a year. And I wonder if you had seen that before 2020 had hit. Because to me, it's been pivotal in a lot of things. It's been a changing point. It's been a turning point. It's been a year where we have seen liberals become brazen. And I think their brazenness is going to hurt them immensely. But I think the world will forever be different after 2020. What did you see before 2020 began? And really, if you can, what do you see for the next coming year, if you're seeing anything at all?
Oh, yeah, a lot. In fact, for the last, I was on Coast to Coast probably 10 or 15 years ago, and George Norrie had asked me, he said, Jeff, what do you think of the Mayan calendar? And I said, not a single thing. I said, I can't come up with a single thing. If you remember, people were out buying, you know, ammunition, holes in the ground. They were, you know, it was just total meltdown. Oh, my God, Jesus is coming and the world is ending, right? But it never happened. And I said, it's not going to happen. I said, I'm really focusing on 2020 as the transformation. You see, if going back to pre-Diluvian times, there was a book called the Books of Enoch, and there's something known as the Great Conjunctions. And it's interesting that this country broke off. I think the formation of the United States was a lot more than people realize. It wasn't just a bunch of pilgrims, you know, getting rid of the king out of England. I think the founders of this country may have had much more going on. That's speculation on my part, but they knew that the Jupiter-Saturn conjunctions only happen every 1,000 years. And then there's what we call subconjunctions that happen every 240 years. Well, the last one that happened was the founding of this country. Now, whether or not they knew that, I think they did. That's my speculation. It's very powerful. That was the beginning of the Industrial Revolution. If you look back through time, I mean, literally, we went from horses and buggies and, you know, tilling the ground with hoes to machinery. And now look at us now. I mean, it's incredible the technologies we have. And I think that they knew that this was the beginning of the Industrial Revolution. Well, guess what's happening right now? The winter solstice of this year. In fact, anyone can go get a little app called Skyview. It's really cool. You can put it on your iPhone or your Android. You can point it up in the sky and you can actually see Jupiter and Saturn are right together. Well, if everyone watches, they will see that exactly join when on the winter solstice, not the day before, not the day after, exactly on the winter solstice. This is unprecedented. I haven't seen anything like this looking back for a couple thousand years. I mean, it's quite profound. And what does it mean in plain English? I think we're going to see a new era of high technology moving in unlike we've never seen. If you remember back, you know, in the 70s and 80s, people said, oh, we're going to be like the Jetsons by the 90s, right? Well, that never happened. Yeah. I mean, not to say that we didn't have some wonderful advancements, but if you see where we're going to be 10, 15 years from now, taking it out 100, you know, 1,000 feet and looking down at the earth, I can tell you, if the astrology is right, and I believe it is, we're going to see advancements in every front, energies, technologies. You know, Donald Trump's uncle, a lot of people don't know this, was actually John Trump. He was in the CIA. He was involved in the confiscation and you know, acquisition of all of Tesla's documents. And Tesla had a lot more stuff than people realize. There's free energies that have been developed that have probably not been commercially feasible. I think we're going to see all this coming through over the next decade. I think it's going to be incredible.
It's interesting. I don't know if a lot of people know it, but there's an entire conspiracy theory about John Trump and his work with Tesla. Right. There was a book that was written like 100 years ago.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
A little boy named
Baron Donald Trump, right? Baron Trump.
Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah. I'm not sure about that conspiracy theory, but that is a very, very interesting angle. I know that in after the show, we are going to do an extended interview, and everyone who is a subscriber to the show, that means you donate monthly, you're going to get to see this special interview that I'm going to have with Jeff, where we're going to dig a little bit deeper into what's going on here in Nevada and what we can expect in Nevada in 2020. But I wanted to ask, because we've got some viewers who are on right now, and they're talking on Facebook and Instagram, and they're basically mentioning that this has been a year with a lot of racial tension. Someone even said that going red would not be good for non-white Americans. We really are in an interesting time where there's a lot of racial struggle. Did you see that happening, and do you see it potentially getting better? Because I honestly hope it does.
Well, I think it's being utilized too. I really do. I think there's forces, you know, people criticize William Barr, but I think he's actually right that a lot of this is funded. They're piggybacking on top of BLM. I think it's being drummed up to be a lot worse than it is. And I've heard that there's this Antifa is being funded. I know I've seen things around here in Burbank, also northern Los Angeles, up in the Simi Valley area, that's been very questionable of what's going on. It really seems like when an event happens, and they were literally, like in Kenosha, Wisconsin, by the way, I was born in Kenosha, Wisconsin, so I know that town well. And I used to do forensics work in that courthouse that they were outside firebombing. But I can tell you that there's evidence, and law enforcement has actually said that these people are being shipped in to piggyback on top of an event when it happens, like Jake Blake. And I'll tell you something else. It was amazing. The astrology wasn't kind of accurate on the COVID. It was so accurate, it was creepy. I was telling people something's going to happen in January and February. And it's exactly what happened. We had the Saturn-Pluto conjunction. And just for anyone listening, Saturn and Pluto, believe it or not, was within days of when World War I broke out. So whenever these 9/11 happened on the Saturn-Pluto opposition, the banks crashed in 2008 and 2009 on these Saturn-Pluto square. And I knew, I said, watch out, something's going to cut loose here. I couldn't see war, but it was a different kind of war.
A different kind of war. And what's interesting about that is you also said that you see a lot of a new type of industrial revolution that's going to be happening here within
technology revolution.
Technology. And yep. I think we're seeing that already, not just with like iPhones and the jets and things, but with the speed in which we're looking at vaccines, with the speed in which we're finding medical breakthroughs, it really does look like we are entering an era, no matter what your politics, where things are going to be happening much more quickly, that the scientific advancements are teaching us things we never would have thought possible even 20 years ago.
You bet. You're exactly right. You're exactly right. It's going to be blazing what happens. And the reason why the infrastructure, I mean, you look at technologies, you know, when the Industrial Revolution happened, you know, it was just at the beginning of machining and metallurgy and advanced techniques like we have. Now we've got that foundation to build upon. And with computer technologies and advancements in genetics and medicine and energy and transportation, it's going to be, I really do. I think we'll see flying cars here in 10 years. They've already got motorcycle cops in Dubai, and they're talking about doing it in various places in the United States with carbon fiber frames. I know the government's been using hydrogen in their drones for quite a while. So it's pretty amazing. I think we're going to see unprecedented changes in the financial systems. And, you know, I have to say, getting back to the politics of Trump and Biden, and again, I'm not promoting Trump or demoting Trump. I'm not promoting Biden or demoting Biden.
You're not telling your own political preferences. You're just saying that this is what you're
trying to be objective as possible. Yeah. And I can tell you, if Biden gets in, China will own this place. And for those who hate Trump, and I know, I talk to clients every day, how could you possibly say anything possible or positive about Donald Trump? And I'm like, well, if you saw his astrology, you might be a little more courteous. Donald Trump operates on abrasiveness. It's how he works. He's a fighter. He's got Mars in the ascendant. He actually gets fueled by the feud. It's what he does.
He does.
But, you know, he's been, you know, charged as being crazy and a lunatic. The astrology says quite differently. I think he's much smarter. I know people who know him and have worked with him, and they say, yeah, he's pushy and he'll bounce you out the door if he doesn't like you. But he's also very, very attentive and gives a lot of people a lot of courtesy to listen to them or to have themselves be heard. And that's what the astrology supports. Different astrologers use different systems, and it's exceedingly complex. But the ones that I use, they're very ancient, and I have to say, I say he wins like a freight train through a wet paper bag. Well, that's what I've been saying.
We certainly hope that he does. Well, I certainly hope that he wins.
Well, but here's the problem. Okay, the astrology shows that the fall equinox, which, by the way, is coming up in like 3 days, okay?
Yeah.
We're going to see some real dissension near the end of the month. Jake, I started mentioning earlier, the COVID broke out exactly on what we call a Kalasarpa Yoga, which was the Saturn-Pluto conjunction and all the planets going in between the moon's nodes. That's where eclipses happen. Every time this happens, there's trouble, especially in the configurations that happened in. Then I said, well, this is going to let up in like May, right? It looked like the astrology was going to let up. But I warned, I said, but we now got Venus going retrograde. The second the COVID started to let up and some of the governors said, okay, we can back off a little bit, right? Some of them. Boom. What happens? The George Floyd thing happens. And boom. Everything goes haywire, crazy. Then that's settled a little bit, even though the dissension is still being funded up there in various cities. What happens? Jake Blake breaks out right on a Mars square Saturn. Exactly. Well, here's the problem. Mars just went retrograde and it's going to square Saturn again right at the end of this month. And I think they're going to, Trump really looks like he wins. Whether or not people like hearing that, that's what the charts say. I think they're going to really skew the numbers. We already know that Biden and his camp, or I should say that his handlers behind him, have already hired like 600 attorneys ready to go at this. And
that is 100% true. And we are going to have more of this discussion after the show for our subscribers. So check that out coming up in a little bit. But up next, we're going to go over the worst, the winners and the losers. Jeff Harman, you have been awesome. We cannot wait to hear more from you. JeffHarman.com. Subscribe to the Michelle Mortensen Show so you can get that content. And we will be back in just about 2 minutes. Have a good one. On Thursday, doesn't even start.